Hey guys, today we're going to be installing an inner fender liner. Before you start your job, make sure to read your instructions carefully and use all the appropriate equipment to secure the vehicle up in the air. We're installing some product from Rough Country, and they are doing an awesome job of developing product for little accessories for your truck. Other videos you saw us do their seat covers, and today we are doing their inner fender liners. Why do you want to have some sort of inner fender liner? So years ago, I noticed that when I was driving in the snow, my truck would just kick up stuff all over the place. And the problem is, you see a lot of trucks start to rust in areas like this because they're kicking up salt and snow and it's just eating away at the metal. So what I did was I just got some mud flaps. You can do something like this, and that helps stop a majority of the crap throwing to the back of the truck. However, you can see here, I have still a lot of openings. I also put one in the front because I also noticed there's stuff being flung up front as well. So what we're doing is we're prepping the area. Grab your 13 millimeter, take out these bolts over here because our new fender liner is going to reuse these. And beforehand, I've cleaned everything out, sprayed the compressed air, heat gun, got all the moisture out. And what you're seeing here is fluid film. I'm choosing fluid film because it stays for a long time. Take a look at my gas cap. You see here all that goopy stuff? That's fluid film from over a year ago. So what I do is, see this pinch over here or the seam? So what this does is it gives the fender strength, but you see it's double layered steel. So we're spraying in here to make sure that if anything gets in here, we're inhibiting the rust. I'm also concentrating on the inside of the fender. This is where you can do, if you don't even want to buy this product, is how you're going to prevent rust from happening, because a lot of trucks get a lot of rust in these areas. So we're just going to create a whole membrane of rust inhibitor. One can should be enough to do both sides, and we're hitting the frame as well. I'm hitting the inside, especially areas like this that support the bed. We're gonna spray all in here because you're not gonna be able to access it later on. Another thing people have done is I've done it myself, is you can get these caps, and that will help keep the tubes for the cross sections of the frame closed. One, it looks better. Two, it keeps the crap from going back into it. There are holes along of these cross members, so you can still put some sort of corrosion inhibitor in there. I've also seen people where they put skirts on. That used to be the thing, is just you put this rubber piece here and you screw into it, or you fasten it somehow. That was the old way of doing it. Now we're doing it in one piece. Completely bone stock, you don't have much further to go. We do have one modification we have to make. So we have Roadmaster Active Suspension here, and we have a little bit of a clearance issue. So we're just gonna take a Sharpie and quickly clearance this. That way we have good suspension movement, and we're not gonna be hitting our inner fender liner. The cool thing about this particular application is the inside bolts that help support the bed are what hold this in place. So you guys can see here, here's this little support brace, and that support brace, what it does is, this is just sheet metal, so if that brace wasn't here, this sheet metal would be pretty floppy. So they reused the bolt there, so you don't have to drill any new holes, unless you choose to, but really these two bolts, the way it's molded in here, it's really going to help hold it in. Now I do have the factory molded mud flaps. On this side, the holes were lined up. I did have to drill new holes on the other side. They're not perfect, but it's not a big deal. And then over on this side, I'm drilling a new hole over here to keep our push pin in. So these are quarter inch holes. Now with all our holes, we are spraying fluid film in there to help prevent any corrosion. Now, if you had the factory fender flares, they do provide enough push pins for you to go all the way around and put new holes in and hold in place. This is the cool thing with this stuff, because it's plastic, it's easy to partially reshape it if you have to. So I have the GM molded mud flaps, and it's not conforming that great in this area, so the way that they molded it. So I'm heating this up, making it more flat. I've drilled another hole in here so that my push pin, my quarter inch push pin will work. I've also made another hole up here because they only have one hole here. So having the extra push pins is going to help it. So here is all in the factory holes. Here, this is just in the mud flap. So I'm not making any new holes in the steel back here. And we are done. So I really like this because it's coming all the way down. So we're covering up all that stuff in the frame. We did have to notch here for our suspension mods, not a big deal. And you can see here, it's working well with our Easy Flares. So Easy Flares is an adhesive. It goes over, so we're really protecting the whole wheel well. And like, there is some openings here, so you're gonna have to hit this, you have to clean this out. You might wanna go from behind and clean it out. Obviously, you're someone who uses a rust inhibitor like fluid film over time, but at least during the winter time, when you're spraying stuff in here, it's just being contained to this. Now, the reason I'm being big on fluid film is because that liner is plastic. So if we read down here, will not harm painted plastic surfaces or oil resistant seals. So that's why I'm big on this. It's not gonna deform all that nice plastic liner that we just installed. Okay, final inspection. Everything looks tight. I really love that they accommodated this ridge in here. And you can see that we have good clearance. Now we had to spray some rust inhibitor over in the exposed part of the frame over there. But now we have lots of clearance from our modification for our additional suspension components. The front end's good. We have lots of room over there. And this is definitely going to catch a lot of the debris flying off of these tires. And there you guys have it. One factory style looking liner. Now I really love how this looks. And the nice thing is, it kind of removes the wheel gap without removing the wheel gap. But because we could see through all the suspension components, we could see where the bed meets the frame, it kind of gave this illusion that we had more of a gap. Now stepping back from the vehicle, it's just this nice super clean look.